Hello students, this is Vivek Srivastava sir and I am here with you to discuss the topic that is related to subject geography and the topic to be discussed here is volcanoes in Hindi Jwalamukhi. Okay, so beta that is chapter number 3rd from your geography book. Let us start the topic volcanoes. First of all, we have to know that what are the volcanoes. It means what is the definition of volcano. So the definition here, volcano is an opening in earth's crust that allows molten rock, gases, and debris to escape to the surface. That means the volcano is an opening. Okay. In other words, you can imagine that it is like a mouth, like a hole. Okay, so that is the opening in the earth crust. In the earth crust, it means in the plain. It means in the mountains. That is the like a mouth, like an opening, like a hole that allows molten rocks. It means with the help of this gap, this hole, this opening, the molten rocks, the gases, and the debris. This all came out. It means escape to the surface. They came out. These three options like rock, gas, and debris that came out on the earth surface, and the magma travels through a narrow passage. Magma. Let us see from this figure. I hope you are able to see this figure. Okay. So see, I have made a chart here. You can say like that is a drawing of a example of volcano. So that is a mountain. That is a mountain. That is magma, okay? That is magma, and that passes through that narrow strip, okay? And goes up, passes through a narrow strip and goes up. So this is a narrow vent. This is known as the main vent. So the magma passes through this main vent and go upside, and from there starting to flow here and there, okay? And flow also on the top of the hill. Okay, so that is the magma, and that portion, beta, that portion, have you seen it? That portion, like this is known as gas and ashes. This is as gas and ashes. Whenever you burn a fire, so you see there some ashes, some gases, some smokes. So this is how magma is like a fire, okay? And you will see there gases and ashes at the top of the magma. So, top of the hill. And this is the crater. This is the crater that is smelling, that vent going up is known as a crater. In the book, you will see it in red or yellow color, and that is that portion. That is lava flows into, it means lava goes up and flows down to the vent, down to the top, okay, down the hill. And that is layer of ashes. In the mid size, there is layer of ashes that go through the magma, through this vent, okay, with magma and go up. So this is layer of ashes. That is made of crust. You know, crust and mantle are the, so that portion is crust, and that small portion is known as the mantle of the earth. So, beta, please see the diagram in your book. As much as possible, I have done on the board, but you can see it very easily from the book. See it in the book and see the video also. Watch the video and see the book at a time. You will properly understand what I am saying. Okay? So, beta, the magma travels through a narrow passes known as when and it reaches to the surface of the earth as lava. Okay, in start when we are starting here, that is known as magma, and then when it go up, it will be changed into lava. Clear? Both are the same things. So beta, now we have to know that how many kinds of volcanoes are, what are the types of volcanoes. So one more thing that should to be discussed here. This lava and material like ash and cinder accumulated as a heap around the vent and a conical shaped hill. The hill is always in a conical shape, okay, like a cone. So the conical shape of the hill or mountain is formed. It means due to this volcano erosion, the shape of that place will be turned into a conical shape. Clear? The top of the volcano is known as crater. I said you that here is magma and it is the crater. Top of the volcano is known as the crater. Okay? So beta, see from the book. And now there are three types of volcanoes. The first one is active volcano. Second is dormant, and third is extinct volcano. So what is active volcano? From the name you can easily understand, active means in action. Okay, so see, active volcano can erupt any moment as the volcanic activities are continuously taking place in them. It means it can be happen anytime. Okay, because volcanic activities are taking places any time to them. So Mauna Loa in Hawaii is an example of active volcano. So write it in your notebook that what will be the example of active volcano. So you have to write Mauna Loa in Hawaii is an example of active volcano. So next, that is dormant volcano. What is dormant volcano? So those that have not erupted for long time. It means this volcano is, ये volcano है, but this is not erupted. Okay? So, but they have to be possibility to eruption to any time, such as Mount Fujiyama in Japan. Okay? Like Mount Fujiyama in Japan. So what is the example of dormant volcano? It will be Mount Fujiyama in Japan. Okay beta? Now third, that is extinct volcanoes. What is extinct volcano? So extinct volcano had erupted in earlier time. Okay, it was happened in the last days, earlier times, but now, but there is no possibility of their eruption. Okay, it was extinct volcano happened in the past, but there is no possibility that will happen again in the future. So this is known as extinct volcano. So Mount Kilimanjaro is an extinct volcano. Okay, so what is the example of extinct volcano? So you will write Mount Kilimanjaro. Okay, so beta, I hope you are getting all the points related to volcano. One more thing, I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please be supportive to us. We will provide more and more valuable things to you. Till then, watch my all videos related to your class, or if you are interested, you can see the videos of your upper classes or lower classes also. Okay then, that's all for today. Have a nice day. Thanks for watching.